So a new Bumblebee trailer was released last week, and do you know what? I'm actually really excited for this film. Bumblebee seems to be finally the film answering fans' problems they've had with the previous five Transformer films, which have been decreasing in quality with every film, and an actual impressive feat considering the quality of Transformers was that after Revenge of the Fallen. Transformers fans have always had problems with the Transformers films, the main critical points being the god-awful design of all the Transformers, the focus on terrible human characters, and poorly choreographed fight scenes involving the Transformers. The Transformers films have been the epitome of Michael Bay films. They're loud, incoherent messes, filled with product placement and a love for the US Army. With the last two films, it seemed Michael Bay became even lazy by his standards when making these films, and your ridiculousness was cranked up to 100. But this didn't stop the money train. The series is now the 13th most successful film franchise. The winning streak of the Transformers films came to an end with The Last Knight, with the film only grossing $600 million worldwide, the lowest grossing Transformers film to date, against a budget of $217 million, being the most expensive Transformers film made to date. It appeared to studio execs fans had finally become tired of the Michael Bay schlock that was being pumped out, and finally given in to fan demand, and made hopefully the necessary changes to make a good Transformers film and keep their Money Cow franchise running. Firstly, before I discuss what Bumblebee needs to do to be a successful film, I want to look at what the film appears to have already done in order to fix the major fan complaints. So, first of all, the most notable change is the design of the character of Bumblebee, and all Transformers for that matter. They've gone back to the original Generation 1 cartoon designs. This is a fantastic choice and a decision I often wonder why the Transformers franchise never made. The Transformers films have always suffered from poor character design, and it's always been very hard to tell apart the characters they're actually fighting, except maybe Optimus Prime and Bumblebee, the only two Transformers to show up in every film. These two characters have a somewhat more distinctive design and are easier for the audience to identify than the various other Transformers which have appeared in various Transformers films. These characters have been seen to audience members as fairly disposable, and you don't really need to pay attention to them. The designs for the Autobots, however, do use some colours to distinguish between one another, but still not great, but are far better than the Decepticon design, where every single one is grey and spindly, I guess so the audience could identify these colours as the bad guys. The Bumblebee film, as mentioned, uses these Generation 1 designs, and it is perfect for the studio and audience. Thankfully, Bumblebee is now transforming into the classic Beetle car instead of the latest Chevrolet car to be released, and we don't have to spend 15 seconds of beauty shots establishing the car he has turned into.
What?
Hopefully, we won't be seeing a scene like that in the Bumblebee film. So why is it good the designs have altered? Firstly, the studio can 100% benefit from merchandise sales. Having a range of Transformers with distinctive designs will definitely interest the kids which see these films, and each kid will now definitely have a favourite Transformer and want that particular toy or the whole set, as now kids can actually tell these characters apart. And from a storytelling point, the characters can now be told apart, and we actually know which character is which instead of the old way of telling the characters apart, being if they have bright colours, good guy, grey and spindly, bad guy. The film appears to be, and I say this with a pinch of salt, appears to be pushing the focus away from the humans and to the Transformers, something which seems crazy that's never been done with a film called Transformers to have never focused on the characters in the actual title of the film, and always followed an extremely unlikable lead character.
You go get insurance on a freaking spaceship. Good luck with that, buddy. Is your car? Huh?
Now, I know there are humans in this film, and seems like we are spending time with these characters, which is fine. A Transformers film does need balance between human characters and the Transformers, as human characters can help guide us through the story, and we can see ourselves through their eyes going through the story. It's also nice to see we're not getting an overly sexualized female character, a strange addition to films that are actually made for kids, that every film had a character there to look good and have basically no impact on the actual story. So I'm looking forward to Hayley Steinfeld's performance in this film. It seems like there's going to be a lot of charm between her and Bumblebee. So okay, let's get onto the subject of this video. What does Bumblebee need to do to be successful? So I know I've gone on a bit of a tangent, but I promise we're back on track now. So Bumblebee needs to do a lot of things. Firstly, it needs to work as a soft reboot for the Transformers franchise. Paramount have realised that interest in these films have fallen quite dramatically, and to get people back on board change needs to happen. So having a prequel probably points towards a soft reboot, similarly to films such as Days of Future Past and The Force Awakens. Bumblebee needs to be able to change perspective of Transformers films and show future films will not follow the Michael Bay path set before them, and the next Transformers installments will follow in this film's footsteps. That for me is probably the easiest part for Bumblebee to achieve. If the film is good and opens itself up to sequels, it will generate new audience interest and give the Transformers franchise the much needed second wind it is looking for. So that is in a sense the easy part. Let's look at the hard part for the film, which the trailer is trying to push, and that is one word: charm. The character of Bumblebee needs to be charming. The fact Bumblebee doesn't have use of his vocal cords definitely opens up some creative avenues for Bumblebee to communicate, and this definitely adds to his charm. Bumblebee needs to be characterized similarly to another great robotic character, the Iron Giant. These characters share many similarities, but communication is a big similarity between these characters. Iron Giant struggles with communicating with humans or expressing himself correctly, but he slowly learns. This should be similar with Bumblebee. Slowly learn how to communicate with humans, a species he has only just met. This should be a charming, fun, and creative story element. Bumblebee, we can only assume, has a genius level intellect, and he is rendered to childlike intelligence due to his difficulties with expressing himself. This will stay very true to the character and will definitely resonate with children watching the film who might be experiencing similar problems with communication, and be a very heartfelt story and a character children and adults can definitely connect with. Characterizing Bumblebee is something Michael Bay got completely wrong. For some reason, he was characterized as a petulant, angry child, easily prone to losing his cool, and Bumblebee was actually a fairly unlikable character. He was arrogant, made rash decisions, but because he was the only other Autobot than Optimus Prime to show up in every Transformers film, he was second in command of the Autobots, despite not actually showing any leadership skills, with Autobots actually acknowledging his childlike tendencies being unfit for leadership.
Bumblebee has held command, despite his complete and total lack of anything resembling warrior discipline.
Bumblebee should be defined as a brave Autobot with some leadership skills, but restricted by obviously his communication skills, but should be a very talented tactician at least. Bumblebee has always been one of the smaller Transformers, but has always been defined in the cartoons for his bravery, despite being smaller and weaker than his other Autobots. He has shown incredible bravery, which in turn has inspired his fellow Autobots, showing despite being restricted by size, it shouldn't restrict bravery. A fairly powerful message, if not a little cheesy and familiar, but these are films made for kids, so it's a nice message instead of kids seeing a petulant child on screen. But there's my thoughts on what the Bumblebee film will need to do to be a success. Current early signs do look good. Two trailers have come out for the film and they have been praised for their charm and character design. And for me, I'm especially happy with the Decepticons design. It's more distinguishable with actual colours being added instead of just drab grey. It gives the characters a little more personality and hopefully makes them more iconic. The film has an excellent director in Travis Knight, known for his excellent animating background with Kubo the Two Strings and the Box Trolls. This will be his live action directorial debut, so it will be interesting to see how he handles the change, but at least he has handled animated characters, so his background definitely lends itself to a Transformers film. We won't have to wait long now for Bumblebee, but the signs for this film look good, and I am currently excited to see how this film turns out, and I can't wait to go see it. So thank you for watching.